Bueno, amigos, seguimos visitando WonderCon. Yo soy Ricardo Méndez y seguimos en el Artist Alley. Y ahora nos encontramos con Jamie Sullivan, que es uno de los artistas oficiales de IDW. So, hi, Jamie. Welcome.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
Talk to us about your work.
I was born in 73, so I grew up watching all of these cartoons like I'm sure you did. It inspires me, and it makes me really happy that I get to draw G.I. Joe for IDW and Robotech for Toynami and Star Wars for Lucasfilm for a living. It's, you know, it's an incredible feeling. You know, I'm a huge fan, first and foremost. I'm an artist second, but I'm a huge fan of all the stuff that I do.
I can see you have some originals over there. Well, you have the exclusives for the IDW covers. But what is your technique? How do you like to do these creations?
Well, I draw everything by hand. I draw everything still traditionally, pen on paper. I don't even use 11 by 17 like most artists. I draw like the Kirby size, the Jack Kirby size. The pages I draw on are 16 by 24. They're really large. And there are things that you can still do on paper that you can't do digitally. When I screw something up on paper, I have to think my way out of it, and sometimes it's a happy accident. Things happen. It's more of a creative journey, you know, finishing something, because it always doesn't turn out quite the way you want it to. Digital, you can cheat. If I draw something, screw something up, I hit back or undo. It's very different. That's why I still like drawing on pen on paper. Coloring is different, you know, I'm just filling in the lines and stuff. But that, I always sit down, I imagine what the image will look like in my head in the layout. I look at it from like a movie poster designer point of view, and then I try and put that on paper. And I hope it comes through. I hope people see, you know, the love that I have for these franchises when they look at the stuff that I draw.
You have drawings, paintings about G.I. Joe, about Transformers. I can see over there, Mask. But I don't see any Voltron or...
Oh, no, there's Voltron stuff in there. There's 80s Voltron and the new Voltron in there. I love Voltron. But you know what's funny about Voltron? I loved it when I was a child. And I have these wonderful memories of Voltron as a child. So I bought when all the 10 box sets came out, you know, with the lion heads and stuff. I sat down and I started to watch it. I was like, oh, this is bad. The memories I had of the show and the animation and the story were better in my head than they actually were. So I kept the box sets, I put them away, and I'm like, you know what? I'll let my kids watch them, but I just want to remember it how I remember it.
Now, what haven't you drawn that you say, I might do this now?
Well, I've drawn Star Wars. I've done some Star Wars Adventures covers for IDW that are coming out as variants, but the one thing I would love to do is I'd love to draw Star Wars for Marvel Comics. I would have liked to have done it when it was a Dark Horse, but it going back to the original publisher, I would love a chance to draw something that was in that original Marvel storyline. That like a dream come true for me. But the next thing I'm working on, I have more projects with Toynami coming out. I have more G.I. Joe covers. I have that big connecting cover that's coming out. That's issues 266 through 270. It's just this... It was a monstrosity to draw. It was almost 8 feet long when I drew it.
Now you told Toynami, and I just remembered, you made the drawings for the toys.
Exclusive, yeah, I do. I did the exclusive for here, for this show. I do all the action figure card art, which they have on display over there. So I did all those. Yeah, I do the box art for Toynami. I do the paintings. The little Veritech, the little Battleoid that's on the box is this tall. The painting is this large.
Well, people can buy your art in publishing and with the toys and sell. But if they actually want to have the prints like you have it here, and well, obviously they can't come to any con, where can find you?
You can find me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Facebook, it's Facebook / JSI and Design. Twitter, it's JSI and Design. And Instagram, it's Jamie Sullivan Illustration. There is a really cool website coming soon where you'll be able to go through there and order commissions, order prints, lithographs, all kinds of stuff.
Bueno, pues ya lo vieron, Jamie Sullivan. Tenemos su arte en juegos, juguetes y coleccionables. Eso está increíble. Ya pudieron ver parte de los diseños. Y bueno, pues son parte de los artistas que podemos encontrar aquí en WonderCon en Anaheim, California. Seguimos, ustedes están viendo juegos, juguetes y coleccionables.